I've come from an era where you actually got away with producing products like this called dickheads.
So why are you still having?
Because hi, I'm JP Drake and I'm a director of Drake's. Been in the retailing business my whole life, so ever since I was this big, walking around with dad in the supermarkets and being forced to sit in an office all night and all day. But my role here is pretty much anything that involves anything that happens in a supermarket. I've sort of slanted it in more recent times to go to a digital, more media channel, because to me, I believe we're lacking in that department. So we've been working on the digital side. We've been working on making sure we control our own media and control whatever word is about Drake's is getting out there. So I've been fortunate enough to be able to have a bit of free reign to do that, but none of that wouldn't have come if it wasn't for all the hard work on the shop floor and learning how the whole business is run. Yeah, as you know, it's been extremely cold, and you know what the cold does?
You tell me.
It makes things smaller.
Well, hopefully they taste just as good. We will be back with more details on fruit and veggies around South Australia with JP and the guys here at Drake's.
What a cheeky boy you are, JP.
Hi, my name's Oliver Sparrow and I'm the digital media creative assistant for Drake's. Predominantly, my job involves me doing the editing, graphic design work and videography work for both JP and also Drake's as well. So when we were filming the infamous retail rap that blew up over social media and on the news of JP giving the bird, we actually thought it was below average. We didn't really like the episode and we just continued on with our other work and didn't think much of it. You're one stunt by sticking the finger up to the camera.
Yep.
And retelling the story of a customer. Do you mind going through that?
Yeah, it's like that. When it happened, I mean, we'd been working on a lot of content, telling the consumers and telling everyone what we were doing in retailing. And that was actually the last minute of a 7-minute retail rap segment.
It wasn't until 2 weeks later when Mix102.3 contacted the social media account asking if they could do an article on JP retelling the story of a man that bought 150 packs of toilet paper and 150 liters of sanitizer. We didn't think much of it. Honestly, it just seemed like free publicity, so we just said, sure, what's the worst that can happen? Holy shit, did it blow up.
And I had my first customer yesterday who said he wanted to get a refund on 150 packets of 32-pack toilet paper and 150 units of 1 litre sanitizer. I told him that. That is the sort of person that is causing the problem in the whole country. We're in doing news reports for Fox 8 and Fox News in the States. We're on BBC, breakfast radio in the UK. Some had Croatian papers contacting us. We had 30 different radio interviews. So the lead up to that was the amount of content we'd actually been putting out, which probably no one really sees. They just see that one.
It was pretty surreal to see that a video that was uploaded 2-3 weeks ago to be blown up. The main cause for it actually getting views on the YouTube rather than just on the article was because we asked them to embed the YouTube video into the article on their website. So this ultimately boosted up the growth of the YouTube channel, and we managed to gain 2,700 subscribers within the next couple of days. And that was from 270 subscribers.
A harsh message for stockpilers.
Now, I wasn't aware of this video until today that there was a dickhead who decided to purchase thousands of rolls of toilet paper from his home, mate. Congratulations, good on you.
It went like,
we actually had COVID week, it's probably week 4, and everyone's getting pretty tired by that stage. And that video that got picked up was how we felt about that person that wanted to return all that hand sanitizer and toilet paper.
During the first week of panic buying, I was still working in Drake's Fruit and Veg. I had worked in fruit and veg for 2.5 years, and it wasn't until JP got word that I was doing a digital media course for uni, and he interviewed me with a hard drive that didn't work, so I couldn't show my work and had to show him my personal travel vlogs of my mates and I drinking, and he hired me on the spot. But when the first week of panic buying occurred, it was pretty scary, to say the least. Just how big the lineups were and how rude the customers were to us, and you know, it was pretty really. And just after that first week, I just said to JP, I don't want to work in fruit and veg anymore. I'd rather just work full time in the digital media team. And I think it was a good move for me personally, considering that I wanted to further my career and I wanted to focus on what I want to do in the future rather than just being a fruit and veg assistant, because that's not the career path I wanted to choose.
I think there's a degree of hoarding that's still going around, but I think at the time that that got released was about week 4 of COVID, and there's a lot of misinformation out there. The media had put out all sorts of garbage. All you saw on any of the main TV networks was about how bad things were, everyone's going to die. And then it was really stressing people out, which caused people to panic. When people saw me give the bird to that guy in the reaction that it was something that resonated with every single person, not only in Australia, around the world. There's a bit of risk involved, but the fact that that part got picked up, actually what I actually said, which they edited out, which was great that the team did, was far more colourful than flipping the bird. So I think we have to make those decisions, and I don't think my actions were unjust for what that person was trying to do. And basically they were profiteering on people that are in harder times, and people were paying $60, $70, $80 for a packet of toilet paper because they couldn't get it anywhere else. Old people especially were buying these things, and it's not acceptable. And if it happens again, I'll do it again, because it's what the people want to hear. People are sick of seeing people so polished that they never make mistakes. And you know, if anyone watches any of our content, Retail Rap, just go watch it. You'll see that they edit all of our mistakes in there. And that's the part about it. We're real people. We're not presenters. We're just doing our job. And compromise of Disney. Ah, compromise. What'd I say? Woolworths. Oh, fuck. Thirsty. When I first saw it, thirsty. When I first. Now people think you're a bit of an influencer, even though I reckon a totally small following. It has been growing quite rapidly, and people do come to us to ask for information and other things about retail. And that was what we were doing with the Retail Wraps. And people see the one video and they go, oh yeah, that's the one video. But it's the 200 videos you've done before that. For me, things changed. Yeah, we started to be a bit more serious about the content we were putting out, to be a bit more religious on, hey, let's make sure we get the content. But we also had a lot of approaches from people offering us their merchandise, they want to talk about it, or can we do a collab with them? So all of these things open, because I think that all comes out in the person's personality. And what you saw from me was a good indication that this company is a fun company to work for, and that's what we want people to understand as well. As we've all seen, it can be a very stressful time for everyone, and everyone has had someone that's affected in some way or another, whether it's people that are living in Victoria or not. And it's how you handle yourself, and it's so important to just make sure that you're surrounding yourself with the right people, making sure you've got people to help you if you need it. For me, I believe we're getting on top of things. We've done a fantastic job here in Australia, and let's face it, South Australia has been proven to be the best place to live in the world, and I'll say the safest place in the world. Everyone's just gotta wash their hands.
You should wash your hands, you dirty pig.
Obviously, there's a lot of mental health issues that has arisen throughout the coronavirus, and in particular for those that are in lockdown. So if you ever need to talk to someone or reach out for help, make sure to contact these numbers that are on screen now if you are experiencing any mental health issues. Thanks.